Oh, hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in this wonderful world. And welcome back to my channel. Today's video is about photography. I'm gonna talk to you about how I used one camera and one lens plus my phone to shoot on our trip to Italy in May 2023. The trip lasted for about 10 days. And most of the time, we stayed in two cities, Florence and Rome. As a photographer, I had considered this trip as a great opportunity to do a little travel photography. Before the trip, I was struggling about which camera and lens to bring with me. I actually made a video not long ago about how I finally made the decision to pick up only one camera and only one lens for the entire trip. In that video, I also shared some of my favorite pictures that I shot in Florence. If you missed that video, I will leave a link in the description down below. Please check it out. In today's video, I will share with you my shooting experience in Rome, and I will also show you some of the pictures I took in Rome. Like Florence, Rome is a city with a very, very long history. Everywhere you go, you see houses, cathedrals, statues, fountains, all of which are hundreds or even thousands of years old. Seldom do you see modern buildings in Rome, although it looks more modern than Florence. Unlike Florence, where all the tourist spots are basically within walking distance, Rome is a much bigger city, and you have to take the subway to get where you want to go. But the subway system in Rome is very convenient, so getting around is not difficult. From a photographic point of view, if you only want to do a little travel photography, you don't need too much camera gear. But you do need a good camera with high dynamic range and good low light capabilities, such as a full frame camera, because the buildings, statues, cathedrals you see as a tourist are often under direct sunshine, which creates a sharp, harsh contrast. And once you are indoors, which is quite often, you have poor light conditions. So, a good camera with a wide aperture lens is necessary. I had my Canon EOS R with the 24-105mm f4 lens. In situations where I needed a wider lens, I used my iPhone, which has an ultra-wide lens. I think it is a good camera setup for travel photography, although I have to admit that it was a little bit too heavy. I could feel it, especially after a long day's walk. Rome is especially a good place for street photography. Its architecture, different historical sites, and especially the people, including tourists on the street, will offer street photographers many good opportunities. As a matter of fact, I met quite a few people who were shooting on the street, and from the way they shot, I knew they were professionals. Unfortunately, I'm not a good street photographer, so I only tried a few times. Having said that, I did bring back a few photos that I'm very happy with. Now, let me share them with you. I would like to start with a couple of pictures that I shot at the Spanish Steps, which is a very, very popular and hot tourist spot in Rome. Oh, by the way, for those of you who are wondering why I'm looking down, I'm actually looking at the pictures on my iPad. And for each picture, I will tell you the behind-the-scenes story, if there is any, and I will explain to you how I took this picture and why I like this particular picture. By the way, you must have noticed that I'm filming this part of the video at a different time, and that's because I was disrupted by the big noise outside. People were cutting grass on my front and backyards. So that's why. Now back to the Spanish Steps. Yes, it is very famous because of its long history, which I think is nearly 300 years. It is said to be the largest of its kind in Europe, well designed and well built, and it looks beautiful. The Spanish Steps is also famous for another reason, which I think is more important. It was the scene where the very popular movie Roman Holiday was shot in 1953. The famous movie tells a romantic love story, and together with the beautiful actress Audrey Hepburn, the movie immediately won the hearts of millions of people throughout the world. And Audrey Hepburn became a household name. Since then, people from all over the world have come here to seek opportunities of meeting people and falling in love, which I think is perhaps the major reason why we saw a lot of young people there. I shot this picture with my iPhone, and it was around 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Apparently, the stairs and the church in the background face west, because everything in this picture is under direct sunshine at this time. You know, the sun is already in the west. But the sky is dark blue because a shower was expected very soon. As I said many times, the difficult part of travel photography is that there are too many people in your frame. Now, usually what I do to work around big crowds are two methods. One is to use long exposure, which to some extent can get rid of moving objects from the frame. But this method is not always successful because there are always some people who either sit somewhere or stand somewhere for a long time. Now, the second method that I often use is to come back either very early in the morning or very late in the afternoon and hope there will be fewer people. Now, this is another shot that I took at the same time. I find this picture very interesting. I remember I saw this young girl standing in the middle of the stairs and posing for her photographer. It immediately reminded me of the romantic story of the movie Roman Holiday. I thought to myself, this could be the beginning of another romantic story. So I took the shot. Now, this picture was shot the next day, and you know, I was hoping to take a picture without too many people in my frame. So I came back to the Spanish Steps and shot this picture around 6 a.m. in the morning. I was hoping for some clouds and colors in the sky during the sunrise, but it was an overcast day. The sky looks gray and dull in this picture, but the sculpture of a fish in the foreground is colorful because I think of artificial light. Even at this early hour, a number of tourists already showed up. You can see some people sitting on the stairs. I was using long exposure, hoping to eliminate some people from the frame, but apparently with little success. But I'm pleased that this shot is much nicer in colors than the previous pictures, and it is good in terms of composition. And unlike the pictures I shot the day before, there are fewer people in this image. So it gives the viewer a much better view of the Spanish Steps. Now this picture, I'm sure everyone can recognize this picture as the Colosseum. The shot was taken with my Canon camera with the 24-105mm f4 lens at its wide end. I love this shot, particularly about the light. It was late in the afternoon. A heavy shower was coming, dark clouds were rushing in from the east. However, there was bright sunshine coming from the setting sun in the west, which illuminated this side of the Colosseum. The dark clouds in the sky and the bright Colosseum walls create a unique atmosphere, which has a special impact, I'm sure, on the viewers. It is as if the Colosseum was telling people, "Look at me, I'm the witness of history. I saw the rise and the fall of the Roman Empire." Now, this next picture is also the Colosseum, but I use my iPhone to take the shot. By this time, it had cleared up, so the sky looks nice and blue in this picture. I like this picture because it gives the viewer a very clear overall view of this ancient building. Besides, the use of ultra-wide lens emphasizes the hugeness of the Colosseum. Now, this black and white photo was my attempt at street photography. I was standing on the corner of this roundabout with my Canon camera. I deliberately slowed down the shutter speed, hoping to catch the movement of the running cars. I wanted to create a contrast between history and modernity. For me, history is the building, the statues, and the brick-paved ground. And modernity is the running cars, of course. And from this picture, you can also see what the Roman streets look like. In Rome, seldom do you see paved streets with asphalt. Most streets are paved with bricks or paper stones. Now, this picture is the Trevi Fountain, which is another very popular tourist spot in Rome. It was shot with the ultra-wide lens of my iPhone. The place was so packed with tourists that it was impossible to take a picture without too many people in your frame. This was actually my second time to be here. The first day it was even more packed. So I told myself I had to come back another day. But to my surprise, when I came back the next day, actually very early next morning, there were already many people. This picture is the best I could get. Now, this picture was taken inside the St. Peter's Basilica. I'm not sure if I pronounce this word properly. And what is so special about this picture, of course, is the so-called Tindo effect of light. It was late in the afternoon, and the sun shines through the windows in this picture. And because of the smoke inside, it creates a special effect. This picture also demonstrates that back in the old days when there was no electricity, people were very smart. They were smart enough to know how to use natural light. Now, for the sake of time, I will not talk with you about the other pictures. Instead, I will just put them on the screen. I hope you will enjoy all of them, and thank you. Those are the pictures that I wanted to talk to you about and show to you today. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.